Hi, welcome to Nagesh Biology online classes. Those who have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe, like and share to your friends. So let's discuss about a topic, chemiosmotic hypothesis. This hypothesis otherwise known as chemiosmotic theory. So it is proposed by Peter Mitchell, scientist. This concept explains, or this concept helps to understand ATP formation in the photosynthesis process and as well as in respiration process. So here the ATP, energy currency of the cell, that is produced during light phase in chloroplast, and as well as ATP also produced during respiratory process. So Peter Mitchell, first time he explained clear information about synthesis of ATP in chloroplast and as well as synthesis of ATP in mitochondria. But in the mitochondria and the chloroplast, the mechanism of chemiosmotic hypothesis is same. There is no difference, because protons, whenever they pass through F0 F1 particle or coupling factor, that helps to synthesis of ATP. Now we are going to discuss detailed information about how ATP synthesis occurs in chloroplast. ATP formation in chloroplast and mitochondria, it is the same, but the difference, accumulation of protons only different in chloroplast and mitochondria. So the chloroplast, protons are accumulated, or H+ ions accumulated in lumen of thylakoid. But whereas in mitochondria, H+ ions accumulated in intermembrane space, that is otherwise known as perimitochondrial space. That is only difference between chloroplast and mitochondria, that is accumulation of protons. This chemiosmotic hypothesis clearly explained by Peter Mitchell. So he also received Nobel Prize. So ATP formation occurs in only chloroplast means wrong statement, because ATP synthesis occurs in chloroplast and as well as ATP formation also occurs in mitochondria. That synthesis of ATP in chloroplast and mitochondria both explained by Peter Mitchell, because the same complex, that is F0 F1 particles, are involved in both cell organelles, that may be in chloroplast or in mitochondria. Chemiosmosis requires, what are needed for formation of ATP in chloroplast and as well as in mitochondria? Compulsory, what it requires? A membrane is needed. Compulsory membrane is required to form the ATP. Next, a proton pump. Next, a proton gradient. So gradient, nothing but a difference. At one side should be more concentration, another side should be low concentration, that is the protons. Next, that is ATP synthase. This is one enzyme the needed for synthesis of ATP. That these are the four components are required for ATP synthesis. So a membrane, the compulsory, that may be chloroplast membrane or mitochondrial membrane, compulsory needed for ATP formation. Proton, but it is the structure helps to passing of the protons. So proton gradient, gradient nothing but, so one side should be more protons and the other side should be less protons. The concentration of the protons, it should be different. So then only protons can pass through F0, F1 particle. So that helps to formation of ATP. So protons that should not be same in lumen and stroma. If they are same concentration, there is no chance to movement of the protons. The gradient nothing but difference. ATP synthase, it is an enzyme. It's compulsory needed as a catalyst. It helps to synthesis of ATP. The compulsory, the chemiosmosis requires these four components. Now we discuss how ATP synthesis exactly occurs with the help of chemiosmotic hypothesis. So now already we know very well about the jet skin pathway, that is also called non-cyclic photophosphorylation or non-cyclic electron transport system. In the jet skin pathway, two photosystems are involved, that is PS2 and PS1. These two photosystems are involved in jet skin pathway. Both the photosystems, that is PS2 and PS1, both the photosystems are embedded in the membranes of thylakoid. Whatever this structure is there, this total two lines, that middle space, that is total thylakoid membrane. This is total membrane of thylakoid. So this is the membrane of thylakoid. But that membrane of thylakoid, it helps to occurrence of jet skin pathway, that is non-cyclic electron transport system. This is total membrane of thylakoid. The total electron carriers are embedded in the membranes of thylakoid. The electron, whatever electron excited from PS2, that finally reaches to NADP+. That electron carrying total components are embedded in the thylakoid membrane. So this is total enlarged structure, enlarged diagram of thylakoid, one single thylakoid. The whatever space found inside the granum thylakoid, that is known as lumen. The inside the thylakoid there will be empty space, that entire this empty space is called lumen. Two photosystems participates in jet skin pathway. That non-cyclic photophosphorylation that occurs in membranes of thylakoid, that is play important role for accumulation of protons in the lumen of thylakoid. So once we see how exactly this mechanism helps to formation of ATP through chemiosmotic hypothesis. Once here the photosystem 2 will be there, that is excited, that the chlorophyll A of the photosystem 2. Now here either photosystem 2 or photosystem 1, both consist reaction centers, that is chlorophyll A. But here chlorophyll A of the PS2, that is oxidizes or excite because of the sunlight. That photons, so mainly photon, whenever photon energy, that is quantum energy, reaches to PS2, that excite and releases electrons. But these electrons are carried through various different electron carriers up to PS1. But here the most important thing, whenever electrons are passed to plastoquinone, that is located outer side of the membrane, that is the thylakoid membrane. Plastoquinone located outer side of the membrane. Most important thing about plastoquinone, because of plastoquinone cycle, here PS2 electrons, whatever excited because of light energy, so those electrons are transferred to plastoquinone. So if the plastoquinone, so for example, if it takes two electrons from PS2, so that plastoquinone, if it takes two electrons, So at the same time, it also takes two protons from stroma. Outside stroma will be there. So from stroma, two protons from PS2, two electrons. That two electrons or two protons are used by the plastoquinone. Then it reduced to PQH2. That is a reduced plastoquinone. Now plastoquinone, it is reduced PQH2. That PQH2 reduced plastoquinone, it translocates two protons into lumen. At the same time, that electrons are transferred to cytochrome B6 and F. That electron carriers, the next remaining electron carriers, whatever will be there, those electrons are shifted to, accepted by the neighboring electron carriers. The total electrons are passing like this, plastocyanine. So plastocyanine, it is located inner side of the membrane. That plastocyanine, it consists of copper containing mobile electron carrier, that is plastocyanine. At present, electrons are passing through like this channel. Now electrons are transferred from plastocyanine to PS1, that is photosystem 1. Now here one thing, the main concept, at the time of transfer of electrons through electron carrier chain, so there are different electron carriers will be there at the time of passing electrons. So what happens here, two protons per two electrons. What we can consider here, while passing one electron, it translocates one proton from stroma to lumen. For two electrons, if we'll take two electrons, two protons, then PQH2 is reduced. Now PQH2 reduced plastoquinone, that immediately it again oxidizes. At the time of oxidation, PQH2 again oxidizes to plastoquinone. It translocates protons into lumen, electrons into next neighboring electron carriers. So here plastoquinone, with the help of cytochrome complex, that cytochrome B6, cytochrome F, here because of plastoquinone cycle, so it includes cytochrome B6 and cytochrome F, because all these together helps to occurrence of one cycle, that is quinone cycle. But this plastoquinone cycle so helps to accumulation of protons inside the lumen. So protons are coming continuously from stroma to lumen. So protons number gradually increases because of plastoquinone. Now electrons are passed to PS1. Now this PS1 also excited because of light energy. So that is a sunlight, that is a photon energy. So that is a helps to excitement of PS1. So PS1 oxidizes, electrons are transferred to pyridoxin. So from pyridoxin to electrons that reach to NADP+, then it is reduced to NADPH. Here one important point, so compulsory to reduce NADP+ to NADPH, it requires two electrons. So NADP+, that is reduced to NADPH. But here electrons, this NADP+, it gains electrons from pyridoxin, but whereas it takes proton from stroma. Now here the protons, to form NADPH, protons comes from stroma. So here the stroma protons are used by the NADP+ to form NADPH. That is one important point. NADPH also produced in the stroma region only, because so here FNR, that is enzyme FNR, that FNR otherwise known as NADP reductase enzyme. So that FNR enzyme, that is located outer side of the stroma. So that it is the reduction of this NADP plus to NADPH also occurs in stroma because of location of FNR towards stroma. FNR full form ferredoxin NADP reductase, that is the name of the enzyme, that FNR otherwise known as NADP reductase. So here in the jet stream pathway only NADPH is produced because that FNR or NADP reductase enzyme that is located towards stroma. Due to presence of this enzyme, NADPH is produced. But here the continuously because of plastoquinone cycle, so here continuously protons enters into the lumen. That is one more important point. So here whenever protons accumulates, so gradually what happens here, the pH value decreases. But here the source of protons are two reasons are there. So how protons accumulates in the lumen, so there are two reasons are there. One main reason, that is because of splitting of water. So water will split near PS2 because OEC center that is located towards lumen side near PS2. OEC center, oxygen evolving complex, that is located towards lumen near PS2. So photolysis of water or water splitting process, it never occurs near PS1, never occurs due to lack of OEC center near PS1. That oxygen evolving complex, it made up of manganese ions, calcium and chloride ions. These total different ions will be there in the OEC center. This center helps to splitting of water. The process of splitting of water, that is called photolysis. Photolysis of water occurs in towards lumen near PS2. Reason for that, due to presence of OEC center near PS2, that whenever water will split, so it leads to formation of, for example, if you take one water molecule H2O, it leads to formation of half O2 and two protons, two electrons. The protons, electrons and oxygen, that depends upon number of water molecules. So oxygen is produced in the lumen only. So here the whenever photolysis process occurs, splitting of water, that leads to production of oxygen and as well as protons, electrons. But that oxygen, whatever produced in the lumen of thylakoid, that oxygen comes outside through stomata to atmosphere. That oxygen only used by many living beings during respiratory process. So what we discussed here, protons continuously produced because of splitting of water. This is first reason. Just now I said that two reasons are there for accumulation of protons inside the lumen. So first reason, water, splitting of water that leads to formation of protons. And as well as, so whenever electrons are passes through ETS, so here plastoquinone cycle, it helps to translocation of protons from stroma to lumen. There are two reasons. First, to splitting of water, because of quinone cycle it operates, no? That also helps to transport of protons into the lumen. So the gradually inside the number of protons increases. These protons, so the protons, they comes outside through specialized channel, that is otherwise known as the specialized channels, that is F0 F1 particles. That F0 F1 particles embedded in the membranes of thylakoid. So that is what you call ATP synthase. That is also called F0 F1 particle. This F0 F1 particle, once you see here, the whatever part, this is F naught embedded in the membrane. This is F1. This F naught F1 particles helps to synthesis of ATP. How exactly ATP will form? So protons gradually increased inside the lumen, that helps to maintenance of high proton gradient inside the high proton, high concentration of the protons that is maintained inside the lumen. These protons passes through F0 F1 particle that helps to formation of ATP. Now ADP plus inorganic phosphate that will be in the stroma region. Already adenosine diphosphate, inorganic phosphate that will be in the stroma region. Whenever two protons passes through F0 F1 particle, that helps to synthesis of one ATP molecule. You may get one doubt. So there will be, what is the reason to form ATP because of F0 F1 particle? Here that is, that consists to one enzyme that is known as ATP synthase. This ATP synthase enzyme that is found in the F0 F1 particle. So this enzyme helps to formation of or synthesis of ATP. So two protons are needed for formation of one single ATP. The in this concept what we can understand, so chemiosmotic hypothesis, that ATP formation like this only occurring in the chloroplast. This is explained by Peter Mitchell. But here the most important thing, it is the light phase reactions. Chemiosmotic hypothesis, it is related to light phase only, or light reaction, or photochemical reactions. Once you observe, so exactly three important components are formed, or three products are formed during light phase. So once you see the jet stream pathway helps to formation of NADPH, that is stroma region. So because of splitting of water that occurs, no, that also helps to liberation of oxygen. So the jet stream pathway along with chemiosmotic hypothesis helps to synthesis of ATP. See, in exam what type of questions you can expect? What is the location of FNR enzyme? FNR enzyme that is located towards stroma, that is one important point. How many electrons are needed to reduce NADP plus to NADPH? 2 electrons. Next, how many photosystems needed for jet stream pathway? That is 2 photosystems. So next, mobile electron carrier in the jet stream pathway. Here there is plastocyanin. About plastocyanin, it is copper containing protein. That is located towards inner membrane of the thylakoid. So here the plastocyanin, it is located inner side of the membrane. One more important point, that is mobile electron carrier. So it is a movable electron carrier, that is plastocyanin. But here the most important thing about plastoquinone, while transferring electrons to the neighboring electron carriers, while transferring electrons, the plastoquinone also transports protons from stroma to lumen. That is the most important point about PQ or plastoquinone. Once in the exam here, this is total F0 F1 particle. F0 particle that is embedded, this F0 component that is embedded in the membrane of thylakoid. But whereas F1 part, it is facing in the stroma. So F1 region you can observe ATP synthase, that enzyme helps to synthesis of ATP. But once you observe protons are transporting from high concentration to low concentration. So here high electrochemical potential gradient will be there inside. So the protons migrates from lumen to stroma region. That is through F0, F1, these are proteins. Because of F0, F1 particles, the protons are transporting, no? That we can say facilitated diffusion, movement of the protons through F0, F1 particle, that what we can say, that is facilitated diffusion. Because ATP energy not utilized, but movement of the ions from high concentration to low concentration through proteins. This is protein molecule only, F0, F1 particle, proteins, that helps to movement of the protons from lumen to stroma. That is a type of diffusion, facilitated diffusion, because carrier protein is there and high to low concentration and ATP not utilized. Now the finally what we can understand, because of F0, F1 complex, so whenever protons are passes through F0, F1 particle, that helps to synthesis of ATP. In this concept, what we can understand, ATP synthesis occurs in stroma and NADPH is formed in stroma. Oxygen liberated in the lumen. That you can understand with the help of chemiosmotic hypothesis. So it helps to formation, it explains formation of ATP. Now we discuss about ATP synthase, that structure. So the totality is also ATP synthase. So what are the main components will be there in the ATP synthase enzyme? So once you see whatever structure, the like this I am drawing, that is, this is a membrane of thylakoid. So that membrane of thylakoid, it consists, so what it consists to here, once you see carefully, this consists of two components, that is F0 and F1 component. But here F0, F1 components will be there. It F1 particle, it consists, that is a catalytic enzyme, that is ATP synthase. But there are different names are there for this. So here what are the names? So first name, this total component, we can say that is ATP synthase. Because it consists of this total component, or this total complex, it consists of ATP synthesizing enzyme, ATP synthase enzyme. That enzyme helps to formation of ATP. Now this is otherwise known as coupling factor. There are different names are there for this F0, F1 particles. Coupling factor, F0, F1 particle. This is one more name is there, that is CF0, CF1 particle. So one more name, these are also called oxysomes. This is also called elementary particles. This is also known as smallest rotatory machines in the universe. They are very small in size. Smallest rotatory mission in the universe. Because of this total structure, so what happens whenever the two protons passes through F0, F1 particles, two protons whenever passes from stroma to lumen, it helps to synthesis of ATP. Now ADP plus inorganic phosphate, these are found in the stroma. So adenosine diphosphate, inorganic phosphates will be there in the stroma. But when they combine, so because of a force, whenever energy liberated while passing through F naught F1 particle, the two protons that helps to formation of ATP because of that enzyme catalyst is there. ATP synthase. There are different names are there. So for this, how many ATPs are formed for two protons? One ATP is formed for two protons. So next, location of F0 particle. F0 exactly embedded in the thylakoid membrane. What is the location of F1 particle? So F1 that is located in the stroma region. So here this is total structure of ATP synthase and different other synonym names related to ATP synthase. In the respiration topic it comes, this is otherwise known as complex 5. So see, once there are 8 different names are there for this complex ATP synthase, this total component we can say ATP synthase. Due to presence of enzyme, coupling factor F0 F1 particle or CF0 CF1 particle, oxysomes, elementary particles, smallest rotatory missions that it rotates while passing the protons. No, complex 5. This complex 5, it is we will discuss detailed information in ETS, electron transport system, in the respiratory topic. So this F0 F1 particle otherwise known as complex 5. Like this, there are different terms or synonyms are there for this structure.